Good evening. We welcome you to this glad union tonight. This is one for the ages. And as we're here, we joyfully are gathering together to witness this union of this couple who found each other, fell in love with each other. They've known each other a while too. And God put this together. And we're so excited for this day. So would you join me as we open our time with a word of prayer? Father God, as we're here, we pray that you would speak to us about the reality of commitment, about marriage and how marriage is good, about the love that Howard and Hope have for one another, and the love that this group of family and friends, that they have for them as well. Speak to us through this time. Touch us, bless us through the word of God. Inspire us, Lord, we pray, through the commitment that they make. That is a reflection of what we were able to see thousands and thousands of years ago in the Garden of Eden, when Adam and Eve made the commitment to one another, and we do the same thing even today. So as we're here, we pray your blessings upon this service, and we ask this now in Christ's name. Amen.
Thanks to God for my Redeemer. Thanks for all thou dost provide. Thanks for times now born of memory. Thanks for Jesus by my side. Thanks for blessed balmy springtime. Thanks for dark and dreary fall. Thanks for tears by now forgotten. Thanks for peace within my soul. Thanks for prayers that thou hast answered. Thanks for what thou dost deny. Thanks for storms that I have weathered. Thanks for all thou dost supply. Thanks for pain and thanks for pleasure. Thanks for comfort in despair.
Beloved, we are gathered here together in the presence of these witnesses to join Howard and Hope in holy matrimony, which is commended to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and solemnly. Into this holy estate, these two persons now come to be united. If any person can show just cause why they may not be married, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. And I don't give a long opportunity on that. So Howard and Hope, I'm going to ask that you would come and join me at this time as we gather together on this holy occasion. And I'd just like to share with you three quick insights regarding marriage. First of all, I want us to be reminded on this day, in the presence of friends and family, that a great marriage must emphasize love. The poet Elizabeth Barrett Browning wrote this letter to her husband Robert many, many years ago. And she said this, "How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach when out of sight. For the ends of being an ideal grace, I love thee to the levels of every day's most quiet need by sun and candlelight. I love thee freely as men strive for right. I love thee purely as they turn from praise. I love thee with passion put to use in my own griefs and in my childhood's faith. I love thee with a love I seem to lose with my lost saints. I love thee with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life. And if God choose, I shall love thee after death. The Apostle Paul spoke on love in the book of 1 Corinthians when he said to all of us that love suffers long and is kind, that love does not envy, that it does not parade itself, that it is not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely. Love does not seek its own. Love is not provoked. Love thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. Love hopes all things. Love endures all things. In verse 8, he says, love never fails. Therefore, as we are here on this day, though physical attraction does play a part in a couple choosing to love one another, this is more than physical attraction. It is more than just emotional affection. The love that we talk about, that we share, and that you share is God's agape love. It is unconditional. It is a God-like love that must be applied in this commitment with one another. Marriage, a great marriage, is also based on the work of love. Even God's concept of love is an action. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life." And it was a work for God. It is also a work for us. Ann Landers once said this. You guys understand this. You've been married and had a commitment. And in this day, you were making a commitment to one another. But Ann Landers hilariously said this. She said, "A successful marriage is not a gift. It's an accomplishment." And that's what we look at today. It takes work. It takes effort. It is not easy. But the Bible does say a lot about it. Hope, Old Testament tells us this in Proverbs 12 and verse 4, that an excellent wife is the crown of her husband. And you are crowning him well tonight. In 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 4, it tells us the wives are beautiful, that a wife's true beauty is not on the outside. Rather, let it be the hidden person of the heart with the incorruptible beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is very precious in the sight of God. Howard, for husbands, the Apostle Paul says to us in Ephesians 5 and verse 25, "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her." In 1 Peter, it says this in chapter 3 and verse 7, "Likewise, you husbands, dwell with them with understanding, giving honor to the wife as to the weaker vessel." This does not mean that Hope is weaker. It just means she's more sensitive. "And as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered." A great marriage also leans on the writings, the holy writings of love. And the best place to learn about love and to learn about marriage is found in the scriptures that we hold to be true. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 14, it says, "The love of Christ compels us." In Galatians 5 and verse 16, it says, "For in Christ Jesus we have faith working through love." And then, in the pages of the Song of Solomon, in the wisdom of Solomon, we see him write about what true love can be between a man and a woman. In chapter 2 and verse 10, Solomon so eloquently says, "My beloved spoke and said to me, 'Rise up, my love, my fair one, and come away. For lo, the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time for singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth her green figs, and the vines with the tender grapes give a good smell. Rise up, my fair one, and come away, O my dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the secret places of the cliff, let me see your face, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and your face is lovely. What great words those are. So as we're here on this day, Howard and Hope, if you are ready to commit to this union based on biblical love, I'm going to ask for you to repeat these vows after me, beginning with you, Howard, if you would repeat this to your bride. I, Howard, take thee, Hope, to be my lawful wedded wife, to love and to cherish, to honor and sustain, in sickness and in health, and in poverty and in wealth, and by God's grace, I shall be true to you as long as we both shall live. Amen. Hope, if you'll repeat this vow as well after me to your husband. I hope. Take thee, Howard, to be my lawful wedded husband, to love and to cherish, to honor and sustain, in sickness and in health, and in poverty and in wealth, and by God's grace, I shall be true to you as long as we both shall live. Y'all gonna get me teared up. You keep this up tonight. Now, Howard and Hope, the gifts that you have chosen to exchange after your sacred vows are your wedding rings. These rings are symbolic of the value of your love for one another and the sterling quality of your commitment. So, Howard, do you have a token of your love and affection to give to your bride as a seal of this holy covenant?
Yes, I do.
If you will take the ring and place it upon her hand, and then repeat this after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
With royal love,
I thee endow.
And all of my worldly goods,
with thee I share.
In the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Holy Spirit. Hope, do you possess a token of your love and affection to give to your husband as a seal of this holy covenant? She's in a hurry.
She was ready.
She was. Repeat this after me, if you will. With this ring,
I thee wed.
With royal love,
I thee endow.
And all of my worldly goods,
with thee I share.
In the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, now Howard and Hope, now in your first act as a couple in love and devotion before God, I'm going to ask for you to join me at this time for a word of prayer. Father, we come before you, and as we are here today, witnessing this glorious ceremony. This is one that I've been looking forward to ever since we first talked. I can remember early on seeing their love grow and seeing their affection increase towards one another over the days, and yet also encouraged by the fact that this couple both love Jesus and they are committed to him. I thank you that before they were together, they served the Lord, and afterwards they will do the same. So we pray your blessing upon this union. We pray for you to give them joyous, happy years together, times of great celebration, of holy love, of compassion that comes from you. For what we see tonight is good, and what we are witnessing this evening is right. And so as we are here, Lord, we thank you for sanctioning and approving of what we do together tonight. Bless them for many days and many years. Give them great happiness, and let their love for you increase not only for one another, but also for you. And we ask this now in Christ's name. Amen.
Savior, like a shepherd, lead us. Much we need thy tender care. In thy pleasant pastures, feed us. For our use, thy folds prepare. Blessed Jesus, thou hast bought us, thine we are. Blessed Jesus.
Gentlemen, now according to the ordinance of God and by the authority given to me by the state of Oklahoma, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Howard, you may kiss your bride. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Howard Hill. Y'all a hug. I'm so happy. Well, folks, listen, we appreciate you guys for attending. It's the desire of the wedding party that you accompany them in the fellowship hall for a reception. God bless you, and you are dismissed.